Hello and welcome. I am Taher. In this video, I will show you how you can install Drupal on your localhost in Linux. On this machine, I am using Linux Lite 4.4. So first of all, you need to visit drupal.org and download the latest version of Drupal. You can download a zip or tar.gz file. After downloading your file, open the downloads folder, right click anywhere and choose open as administrator. Type your password. Now copy Drupal folder. Now copy the Drupal zip archive. Go to file system, opt, lamp and hedocs directory. Now paste it here. Now create a new folder and name it Drupal. Double click on Drupal zip file and now extract all these files in the Drupal directory. You also need to install XAMPP server on your Linux machine. I have already installed XAMPP server. If you don't know how to install XAMPP server, I have also created a video. You can watch that video. So next we need to start the XAMPP server. You can type this command to start the XAMPP server and open localhost in the browser. You should see this page. Now go to PHP MyAdmin page. And from the databases section, create new database for your Drupal installation. I am going to call it Drupal. Our database has been created. Now type localhost slash Drupal in the address bar. Select your language and click save and continue. You can see different options. Select an installation profile. You can choose from the standard, minimal, and demo. Now you can choose from these three different options: standard, minimal, and demo. I am going to choose standard and now let's click save and continue button. Now here you can see two different errors. First one for file system and second one for settings file. So here you can see writable permission. We need writable permission. The directory site. Here you can see the error. The directory size slash defaults slash files does not exist. An automated attempt to create this directory failed, possibly due to a permission problem. To proceed with the installation, either create the directory and modify its permission manually or ensure that the installer has the permission to create it automatically. So now go to the Drupal folder. Here you can see the location. Right click anywhere and choose open terminal here. Now we need to change the permissions for this. Type chmod a plus W and the address. Hit enter. Now reload this page again. Now our first error has gone. Next one has The second error is about the settings file. The settings file does not exist. So you can see here in the instruction. Let's zoom it. The Drupal installer requires that you create a settings.php as part of the installation process. So we can copy file from this location to here. Here you can see sites folder and then defaults, and we have default setting file. Let's copy this file, and now we need to copy it here. Sites default, we are inside here. So just copy and paste and rename this file. Now reload this page again. Now we have another error. It's called the settings file is not writable. So let's make it writable. It's very simple and easy. Now type settings.php, hit enter and refresh this page again. Yes, now you can see both errors are gone. Now you can see we have fixed both of the errors. We have another error, but we can ignore this error because we can continue anyway. So click on this continue anyway link. Now we need to type our database information. So our database name is Drupal that we created earlier. The database username is root for XAMPP server, and database password, leave this field blank. You can click on advanced option to view more options, and you can also add a table name prefix. I'm going to click save and continue. And now you can see our installing has begun. And it will take some time to complete this installation. Now our installation is almost complete. We just need to add our site name and other details. After choosing your regional settings, you can click check, save and continue. If you don't want to receive the update notification and email notifications, you can uncheck these boxes. Now click save and continue. And we also need to change these permissions again. Here you can see a warning message. All necessary changes to sites slash default and settings file. Now here you can see we have successfully installed Drupal on our local Linux machine. Now we need to change these permissions. It's very simple and easy. So first of all, we need to change permission for this directory and then for this file. So you need to type chmod dash v and 755 sites dash default, hit enter, and you can see this message, permissions has been changed. Next we need to type chmod dash v 755 and this time sites slash default set slash settings.php file. Hit enter and you can see we have successfully changed file permissions. Now we can continue using the Drupal installation. When I refresh the page, you can see the error is no longer available because we have fixed the problem. Now you can log out. And if you need to log in again, you can click on this login link or you can simply type user slash login after your URL. And you can now type your username and password to log into your Drupal dashboard to manage your content. Thank you very much for watching this video.